Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Tisha, and today we are doing a post-burn reviews on all the candles I've been burning for the last couple of weeks. So on this channel, I do some makeup related content, some Bath and Body Works, but the Santa Maria is someone that I've watched for quite a bit of time. Well, not quite a bit of time, but for a little while now. And she does a really great job of coming back after she's burnt the candle completely and talking about it and letting you know how it performed overall. And I think that's so important because a lot of times on cold, it does smell completely different than burning, or halfway through the candle, it duds out. And again, if you're looking on here like me to try to decide what you do want to try and what you don't, what you want to get, what you want to skip on, I think these reviews can be quite helpful. So I have a little bit of everything, and I have quite a bit because I haven't done this for a little over 2 weeks. I went back to work full time. I mean, I'm still home a little bit, but for the most part, I'm back at the office. So I was home 24/7 before, so I was burning candles like all the time, but all of these kind of ended at the same time. So I have quite a bit to share with you. So we're just going to jump right in. So I have a little bit from Goose Creek, Bath and Body Works, and some affordable candles, as well as some single wicks this time. So quite a bit to share. The first candle I'm going to talk about is from Goose Creek. It was chocolate chip cookies, and you're definitely going to see a theme. I've said this so many times, I'm sure you're getting sick of it. I have an open concept in a big part of my house, so several of those candles have to kind of go together or at least play nicely together. So a lot of times it'll be all fruity scents or all bakery scents. So this is quite a heavy bakery scented candle week, but I'm also keto, so I do tend to want to smell things I can't eat because I like to punish myself. But the notes on this one, I wrote them down because Goose doesn't put them on there. Packaging, browned cookie dough, milk chocolate, molten hot fudge, candy chocolate, and sugary swirl. And the label on this one was pretty cute. It's got a little milk and cookies. It doesn't have a milk note, so that's nice. I don't like those. They tend to kind of smell a little sour, milky to me. And I'm sorry, I'm still suffering from allergies, but I put off filming all this week trying to get my voice back. And this is as good as we're getting. So, you know, Shrek's bringing you some reviews this week. But it burnt down nice and evenly, all the way down, no issues. Smelled, I'm talking into the container. What's wrong with me today? Smelled nice the whole time burning. Definitely on cold, it smelled like cookie dough. And then on burning, I had more of that, like, are you baking cookies? But it smelled nice the whole time. Paired really well with a few of the other candles this week that I, like I said, in that space. This one I burnt in the kitchen, and I got quite a, I really enjoyed it. I thought about picking up another one, but I don't want to. I'm not on a break from Goose Creek, but when I order, I don't get my order for like a month, like 3 solid weeks to a month. And so I just prefer to wait until I really, really want something, then just go get backups. But this is definitely what I would repurchase because the strength was nice. I'd say it was a 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10 easily. No issues burning. I didn't have to do anything besides trim the wicks like I usually do. So I really, really recommend that one. And we'll move on. So I have so many on my table, I have to actually stick these on the floor when I'm done with them. The other one from Goose that I like this one just a tiny bit better, was Melt My Heart. And this is such a pretty chocolate scent. If you are into that at all, this smells like expensive hot chocolate, fancy hot chocolate, you know, the one with the little artisan design in the top, hot chocolate. So hold on 1 second. And I wrote my notes down here. So then the scent notes, sorry, are milk chocolate, vanilla bean, milky cocoa, vanilla sugar, and dreamy chocolate. And yeah, it just smelled so, it smelled like brownies burning. I figured it would. It smelled really good with the cookie one. Like I said, I smelled like I had some bakery going on. Really strong. This was probably an 8 out of 10 for sure. It burnt pretty well. Almost not as well as the cookies, but I have a little bit left. I'm still waiting on my warmer. Amazon lost it or something. I don't know. I haven't even checked into it. Should be here any day now. So then I can kind of use these other ones up a little bit. So yeah, I really did like this. I don't have much else to say about it. It was a solid candle. I would consider repurchasing. So then I'm going to do my single wicks. I got through a Somebody Loves You, and I know there looks like there's quite a bit left, but this wick died. It's dead. So I did stick this on just a wax melt warmer because it fit on there. they're different than like the candle warmers, you know, so I'll show you the difference maybe when I get it. So there's quite a bit left. I stuck us on a wax warmer all week and it did smell nice over by the wax warmer. It didn't really throw over there, but it never burnt down. So I don't know if my light bulb's getting a little weak, but it is really nice. It was super cute. I had this one in my office and I really enjoyed it. While it was burning, it was great. It was strong. I was going to tell you guys that my single wicks this time were almost stronger than any of the three wicks of the bigger jar candles that I had to share with you. All three of them, I was like kind of blown away. I mean, I do keep them in smaller spaces, but I could smell them in the hallway or outside of the room that they're in. So this one was nice while it was burning. It just didn't give me quite as much as I would have liked. And this wick is like white. It's like completely gone. So I'm gonna have to maybe look into that. I mean, I burn them for several hours at a time, so I don't know if it's something I did. I trim them, so I don't know. But anyways, I did feel like I kind of had quite a bit left. That was my only complaint. I do actually have a backup of this one, so I don't need to repurchase, but it was a good candle. The other one I got through, and I know this is weird, but I had this one in the bathroom, and this one did the same thing. Like you can see over here, I have quite a bit of wax left, but the wick inside is totally gone. And this one didn't burn as cleanly as the others. I didn't do the trick where you can like funnel it. I just kind of let this one do its thing. It was in the bathroom. I don't know why I had this in the bathroom. It's not really a bathroom scent, but I don't think I shared the notes. I did write these down. Just so you guys know, I'm sure you know a strawberry pound cake already. Fresh strawberries, golden shortcake, and whipped cream. With the butterscotch toffee, I really liked this one. I grabbed two. I'm just dropping everything today. Two at SAS. This is caramelized sugar, rich butterscotch, and a dash of sea salt. And I'm going to save the other one for next fall. It's very rich. It's a very rich candy scent. I can smell that sea salt. I can smell the caramelized sugar. It doesn't just smell like sugar. It smells like you're doing something to it, the caramelized. Really nice. I don't know why I stuck this in the bathroom. I was being weird, but really, really liked it. I would want to get that one in maybe a three wick for the fall. That would be awesome. And then my favorite one was Let It Glow. I finally burnt this one. It was in a bathroom that I moved to my office after I finished strawberry pound cake. Same thing with this wax. It just didn't go as far. I stuck it on the wax melting. So it's one of those smaller things with just the light bulb. And it never really burnt the wax down, but it did, you know, put off a scent. So that was nice. The notes are cotton candy sugar, sparkling raspberries, and a sprinkle of love from Cupid. Yeah. This is one that like I would, hold on. Sorry guys, I'm back. I was having a little bit of a sneezing fit because of my stinking allergies. So didn't really want you guys to have to go through that, but I'm good. And then of course my son needed me. So back to the candles. This was my favorite single wick burning. It was just like so yummy cotton candy. I love this. I just got my hands on the sugar coated from the Canada exclusives. And I really love that body care. I just got a spray, but I've been using it quite a bit. I'm afraid I'm gonna go through that one so quick, but I really, really like this candle. I have a pink fairy gumdrop from the winter collection in my collection. And then I also have one more of these. So I want this to come out in tons of different collections. I would buy it in every single one. So we're gonna do the large jars first, and then we'll finish up with my three wicks from Bath & Body Works. I still have like five to go through, so I need to speed this up. This is Pineapple Palm. I got this at Target. I have a video coming. It's a battle of the candles. This one wasn't bad. It was a very light thrower. It smelled better on cold than it did burning. On cold, it had this awesome pineapple, fresh, fruity. There was also the palm leaf smell, and then once I started burning it, it just smelled like that hot burning candle smell, like your birthday candles. Not like it didn't have any of those notes. Kind of surprised it burnt down okay. This was one that I had to use the sorry guys, like these allergies are like, I don't want to film. So I had to use that trick, you know, the tunnel that you build with your candles, and so for over half of this, and I gave up and I was just like, whatever. So I have that video coming with lots of information. I did a battle of the Target versus the Walmart $5 candle. This one's gone. I bought two. The Berry Mandarin is a tiny bit stronger. This was stronger cold, so I started with this one. But that one is a teeny tiny bit more fruity burning. And so hopefully I'll have more to talk about in that video for you guys. And then the next one I did was from Walmart, and it's a Better Homes and Gardens Strawberry Mimosa. This one also, I had to do the tunnel with the aluminum foil all the way, and then I just gave up because I thought, okay, I already got my thoughts together on these candles. This one, however, had a throw. So if it burning nicely doesn't bother you, because like I said, I trim my wax, I do the whole, 4 hours for the first burn so that the wax can kind of use its memory to burn. These two never caught on to that, these two, the whole time. But this one had a throw. I would give this one at least a 6 out of 10. So I could smell strawberries and a fruity drink smell away from the candle. I could not smell this one. So it was kind of unfortunate, but I learned a lot. Sometimes we really get bummed out on the sales or the prices at Bath & Body Works. And I agree with what I've heard so many people say, the price keeps going up because people keep abusing the policies. I could see that. I also don't think it's wrong to have a policy that makes your customers happy at all. But when you're paying $5 for this and don't really enjoy the experience, and you can maybe get this one for like $12 with a coupon and a good sale and just, be more diligent, I would much rather pay the price for these. So my last three are 3 wicks that I got through. I'll start with this one. Hello Sunshine was a tropical spice, and I got this one online the last time they had the 1450, and I actually ordered three because I don't know why I'm that way, but I really like the way this smells cold. Burning, it's just okay. Burning is, it's light, it's not bad. There's nothing funky in it. Let me read you the notes. I haven't done this in a couple weeks and it kind of like got all off of the practice of. So the notes are Tahitian vanilla, fresh coconut cream, dash of nutmeg, cinnamon stick garnish with essential oils. And when you're smelling this on cold, you can really smell that cinnamon stick and the vanilla. I don't really smell a ton of coconut in here. The nutmeg kind of goes with the cinnamon, but then when you burn it, you lose that cinnamon. I don't barely smell any spice whatsoever, which is funny because it's half the name. I don't smell the coconut. The strongest note in here is the vanilla. So when you're burning it, it just kind of smells like vanilla with a hint of something. And every once in a while, it seems a little different. Maybe it is a little beachy or it is a little spicy like cinnamon, but nothing strong. So I'm actually going to return the other two. I have not burnt them. This one I burnt down and it did a really good job. It really, really did. It was the same amount of smell the whole time, so I didn't lose anything. I love the packaging. Let's just take a second. This lid is super cute. I'm gonna keep it to burn some tea lights on. But yeah, I love the packaging. So I might keep one and return one, but I'm definitely gonna return one just because I was ready for this candle to be done, if you know what I mean. Like, I was so kind of like, just hurry up and burn already. And I did, I got it all the way down to here, so that's perfect. But it just didn't excite me, so I don't want to keep it. And so like I said, I've only recently exchanged a couple of candles that I had not burned whatsoever. And I've never bought, again, and this isn't like a you can't do it, you do you. That is definitely my motto. But I've never bought a bunch of candles on sale to return. But if it's like, sometimes on cold, I'll smell something and I'm like, I need more. I need one for my collection and one more to burn because I'm really enjoying this. I didn't do that before I burnt this one. And I don't think I would have bought backups if I would have lit this one, but I bought them together for a sale price. So I have my receipt and I'll take the other two in that are unburned. I did finish this one up because there was nothing smelly about it. It just didn't give off much. I would give it like a 4 out of 10. It just wasn't strong whatsoever. I had this one in the kitchen all by itself. But when I would walk from like the kitchen to the dining room, I could smell this Walmart candle stronger than this. And I just kind of, I mean, again, it was just not a bad candle. Not one I was as excited about on the cold sniff, and also just ordering because I thought everyone that talked about it really raved about it, and I don't disagree with anything they say about it. It just was too light for me. So enough about that, but that was one that I got through this week. I also did use up my coconut cream pie, which I did love this one. The packaging is so cute. I love the little pies on there and the little coconuts. I kind of want to pick up another one. I want to wait till like SAS though. I really just don't need to keep buying so many backups when I want to try so many new candles. It's like I'm two different people, two different candle people. The wax was cream and it burnt down really well, really even. I got a lot of, this was a strong one. I'm going to say this might be the strongest candle I burnt this week besides the little cotton candy. This was the strongest candle I burnt this week. And I don't think anybody else agrees that this is strong, but these were all just super light. So they stuck out to me because they were light candles. The Goose Creek ones were okay. Those are a little bit higher, but not as strong as the Let It Glow. And then this was kind of up there with those Goose Creek candles. I'd say maybe like a 7 out of 10. When I was near it, I could smell the coconut and the bakery notes. The notes are toasted coconut flakes, caramelized custard, golden pie crust with essential oils. I do really like this. I did not buy this in body care too much for myself. I might've got one piece just to have it. Cause I like summer coconut, not as much as bakery coconut. So, but it is a nice scent and I especially love in the candle. So I'm going to be on the hunt maybe for another one. Just cause I really love the packaging and hopefully they just have like a super good sale or they are at SAS. I hate waiting for SAS cause I just don't live by a store where I seem to find the goods. So there's that. But the last candle I got through, this was actually probably the first one that I got through, was a Fiji White Sands. I love this one. You guys know this is one of my summer scents. This packaging is so cute. I held off on burning it, but then I had finished one up and I wanted another one. And so I thought, well, this is another one like the coconut cream pie. I love it. Maybe when SAS comes around, I can snag one up. I'm kind of making that list already. Are you guys doing that? Is that crazy? Not long. Just some candles that like I want to be on the hunt for, or you know, like kind of preparing myself, because again, I don't need anything, so I don't want to just go in there blindly and say, oh, I walked out with $100 worth of stuff. I don't need to do that. But like some candles that I have liked that I might be on the hunt for, maybe a few body care items, just a little list. I'm a list maker, annoyingly so. But the notes on this are fresh cut sugar cane, white nectarine, sandalwood with essential oils. And oh my gosh, it smells like a good smelling man. Let's take a clean man. And like a cologne. I would totally want to smell this cologne on a man. I don't even know what it is about it. Maybe the sandalwood? Probably the sandalwood, right? But it burnt down good and it pretty even. And one of the wicks quit before the other two, so there's a little bit of an uneven burn there at the end. But I love this because it's that luminary style. So as it was burning, it kind of, you know, the candlelight would come through this can. I just thought that was a nice touch. Those are definitely up there for me in some of the packaging lately, because I just like how that glow looks at night. I'm home mostly at night now, so I'm burning these at night and I'm just kind of enjoying the experience all the more. So that is it. That was long enough. You can stop talking now. I appreciate you guys so much for watching these and enjoying these, I hope. Let me know if you've tried any of these candles or what you were burning this week. I am always interested, and leave it in the comments down below. And if like and subscribe if you haven't. I promise I'm not always this rambly. It's probably the allergy medicine. But I will see you guys in a video very soon. Take care of yourself wherever you are. Thank you so much for watching. Love you guys. Bye.